Hi everyone, Lazarkilos here. So today I'm gonna review some Bawaks, but not the old Bawak, but more the Bawak Cals, which were released in 2003 as part of the first wave. And as you may know, there were just two waves of enemies this time, so no Toa waves in 2003. So anyway, we're gonna just see what's new with this new Bawak Cals. And like my older Bawak review, I'm gonna do two Bawaks in this review because they are the same, you know, the clone saga and stuff like that, clone era, if I can say. So I'm gonna do Levakal and Powakal because they were requested by some people on my YouTube channel. So don't forget, you can request some sets. I would like you to request more set and less combo, because less combiner, because I have to take photos of set first, so it can take some time. But anyway, we're gonna do the Levakal first. So first of all, I'm gonna apologize because I bought this set in some garage sale or off eBay, I do not remember. And as you can see, the canisters is pretty damaged on the front. So it's got no front pictures, but you will see one front pictures with Powakal. Anyway, I've got some book right here, so I can show you still the front image of the canisters. So there was this one on it, but I do not know, the kids just do the things wrong, because you are supposed to put off these stickers and not the front one. You're supposed to put the back one so you can see the Bawak inside. And as you can see, the canister is the same as the Bawak one, and we will see that it's not the only similarities with the older Bawak. So the same canisters, as you can see, so no cylinder shape, or at least cylinder shape right here and some stuff like that right there. Anyway, and as you can see, the lid is in green lewa this time, not in some kind of strange green, light green, but in a pure green lewa green, so the normal one. Of course, you find the same symbol of the Bawak, so the same logo. I'm gonna just enter some Bionicle right there. On the back, you kind of got the same stuff, so how to put off the corner, and it shows you can put this on the Toa Nuva head this time. The list of head quanas, so they are the same quana but different colors this time, so no new quanas, no new forms, so the head same, the same head, excuse me. And then the two, so the ball mode and the gimmicks anyway. And here all you supposed to put in the canisters, but as you can see, I do not have the little parts you're supposed to put here to put the Bawakal. So anyway, here's some information, and I think that's all for the canister, so excuse me again for the bad quality of this stuff. And I do not have the instruction booklet anyway, so I'm gonna also show you the instruction booklet of Powakal, but I can still show you this little booklet. Remember, there were some in Bawak and the Toa Nuva, and so you still got one in the Powakal. And again, I think that on some, in some of the Bawak Cal, you got some mini CD ROM. I just got one with my new Cal because I bought it new, and I do not have the other mini CD. So I think I will show you when I review new Cal, the black one. So here's the little instruction. So you can see Tayu Nuva right there with his sword, and the six Bawak Cal, which still the Nuva symbols. Because yes, the Bawak Cal were the elite of the Bawak. There were just six of them, and they appeared on Matanmi to awake the Bawak again anyway. And so to do this, they stole the six Toa Nuva elements. So anyway, that's for the storyline. And then you got some little comics, you can see, with the Bawakal attacking the Toa Nuva. They were really strong at the time. The strongest opponent the Toa had to face. It's like every year the same stuff again and again. Anyway, so here you can see the Nuva cube. And here's some art for all the Bawak. So Nuvok, Tanok, and again with the 8 Quana. Quana call, anyway, it's called like this. And of course, I will review all of them later. I still have to review all the Nuvas and Bawak, so I'm gonna do this later anyway. And here you got some other ad for the stuff released this year. Some Bionicle for the Bionicle game ad right here, the first one. Some Molto One ad and Toa Nuva. And here some Bionicle the movie and stuff like that. With the Wakshi, which will be an important part of Bionicle. And I think that's all for the little extra stuff. So again, I'm gonna show you the more of the canisters and the instruction booklet with Power Cal. But here is the toy itself. So here's Levacal. As you can see, the color scheme is Lewa green and silvers, and some kind of black and gray, white here, gray and some white also. But that's all. The main color scheme is matte green and silver. And as you can see, in fact, the Borokal are exactly the same as the Borok. So LEGO really didn't try to do it original or stuff like that. They do it the same again for a second wave. That's kind of crazy when you think think about it, because it's kind of a rip-off, I mean, because they're exactly the same. But anyway, I'm still gonna review it. So you will for those who haven't seen my English reviews of Tanok and Kowak, I'm just gonna explain how the frame works, how the body frame works. If I just have to put off these body parts anyway, if I succeed. Oh, okay, I was not supposed to do that, so excuse me. I'm just gonna put this on, back on, and yeah, I'm gonna explain how it works. So as you can see, you've got one, this is the main body frame part, as you can see. You've got two of them, of course, and in the middle, in between these two parts, you've got all the gear stuff, so with axle of three right there. So you got three axle, right, no, not axle, excuse me, three gear for the gimmicks, which is the same as the Borok I'm gonna show you later. So you just have to put this right there. And here you got your body frame. Of course, you've got the legs and arms, which are the same. So here are the arms or the legs for who doesn't know about it. So you got some simple connectors and some Borok legs in green, or Borok legs or arm, because they are used on both, as you can see right here. And this time the Borok feet is in silver. And as you can see, they still change the tools or the staff or anyway how you call it, so the weapon. And I think this is a vacuum shield on a Levacal. Kind of nice with some cutters parts. And as you can see, there's just one axle and no pinhole on this weapon. And so you have to put this right there, so like that. And you do this for the two sides, left and right. And then I'm gonna explain you how the head works. So here it is. I think this is the most complicated part of the building anyway, on the Borok and Borokal. So as you can see, you have different, I'm gonna explain this. Yeah, I'm gonna maybe put off this rubber band right here. So I do not remember if I explained this in my Borok review, but anyway, here you go. So you've got this head part, which were also introduced with the Borok. Remember, the Borok introduced with them like 90% of new parts, and so the Borokal are just 90% of reused parts. So here is the head part, as you can see, with some axle and some parts like this, which will be useful to put on the elastic. So I'm gonna put this on these gears anyway, right there. Of course, I think we can, yeah, I think we can, yeah, I'm gonna put the two right there. Then on, as you can see, there are tons of axle hole and pinhole, excuse me. So on this pinhole, I'm gonna put this part, which is the Quana holder, as you can see. And as you can also see, you've got some new Quana colors, of course. So this is a new, this type of Quana was also released in the normal form, so nothing new, but the color is new, as you can see. Some green metal. Green metal, yeah. So you put like this, and then you put the eyes. So this is the same and red this time. And I think that's Levac still, the first Levac got also where the trunks were high. So put like this, and then you have to put the two teeth with some large pin, as you can see, of three, with the face part, the face top part, as you can see. So this one is not in. Remember, the first one was with some colorful part and some clear parts. This one is totally in silver plus some new shape of green. As you can see, you see the shape of the weapon, of the Levakel weapon, on the center, on the middle of the part, right here. And I think all the shape right here change with the Borokal. And then I'm just gonna put the rubber band, no, elastic, excuse me, right here. And then I will show you the gimmick. So that's kind of all. So the gimmick is the same as the Borok. So you just have to push down this lever, and then, as you can see, the head lunge forward. So it's really simple, and of course with the elastic, it come back in its initial position when I just put off my finger. So it's the same gimmick. It works as fine as the first one. Then you've got, of course, the little head gimmick. So you open this part, and then you can do this to launch the Krona. So it's kind of useless, but anyway, it's still there. And of course, this part stands nicely. As you can see, you can't put it off easily. And then you've got the final gimmick of the set. Of course, it's the bell transformation, the ball transformation. Excuse me. So I'm just gonna put this like that, yeah, right here. So it's all about just rotating the parts, turning them right there. Maybe I'm gonna show you it in front of the camera. And there you go, we got the ball mount. You can see right here, so just gonna do a little turnaround of it. And of course you were supposed to put this in the canister like that. So it kind of works and kind of nice. It's like the Borok, so anyway, the Borokal are clones of clones, so they really do Lego really, I think do their best on this one. Just ironic anyway. And here they go. And of course, for the application points, you've got two ball joints on each limbs. The arms and legs, as we can see. And of course, the head doesn't have any point of application, just one to move forward anyway. And so you can still do some pose with them, like that, for example, for terrifying Matawan and stuff like that. And I think that's quite all for the Levakel. I'm just gonna do a little turnaround of it, and then we're gonna I'm gonna talk about the Powercal set right now in the same review. So I think that's all. If you have any question on Levakel, just ask them anyway. I will answer them. And then here we go with Powercal. So as you can see, the lid this time is in brown, right here, and a normal brown patch brown. As you can see, there's a mention of a mini CD one right there, and I do not have this one. So here's the front box. As you can see, this is the shape you will find on the Borok's head. So of course, with some brown background, with some rocks and stuff like that, some sand. And I put all the stickers on the back, of course, to show you. So as you can see, the Borok symbol, or the Borok symbol, Borok swarms, and the little parts to put the Borok on. Okay, and I think that's all. This is the same as the other. Then you've got, of course, the same little stuff in there, but I'm gonna show you the instruction booklet this time. So here it is. We've got some nice image of Tanokal, I think, yeah, Tanokal, which kind of go out of this swarm stuff, of these Borok canisters. What are we? Yeah, here's the transformation, the fact you can put this in the canisters, the combo model, you can see, and here's the Keita. And What I've yes, we've got some nice sweet background pictures. So the island of Matanui right here, and then the Boracal unleashed, and some pictures of all Boracal using their powers, which are in fact a screen caps of the little video you can find on the CD-ROM, because each Boracal got a little video around 6 or 7 seconds of a CGI video, which was kind of nice. Here some Galactal with the universe symbol. And here you can see that's Tau some kind of weak from the fact that the universe symbol was stolen. And of course, the Toa this time have to recover again some Kanoi mask. You can see some Exotoa right here, the back, and some Boracal, which I think will destroy the Exotoa really easily. Yeah, you still find one in the little background right there. But anyway, and then you got the nice group pictures of other Boracals. This picture is really nice in my opinion, kind of cool. They really look like some elite of the Borg Swarm anyway. And here are the pictures of the six ones. And I think that's all for the introduction booklet. I'm gonna talk about the Power Cal now, but really quickly, because you have already seen four Borg, I think. So this is the same this time, but the color scheme is in pretty brown and some silver. And that's quite all, as you can see. So of course they change the weapon, and I think that's some plasma shield. Let me look for it. Yeah, some plasma shield which can superheat any substance and turn it into molten liquid, thanks to this guide, official Barnacle guide anyway. And yeah, so I'm just gonna do a little turnaround. So new weapons, of course, new colors, new parts right here with, as you can see, new shape of this form, and the shape of the weapon at the middle, of course. The eyes are in dark green, dark trans green. If I open this, you've got the again some dark green metal corona right there. And that's quite all for Power Cal anyway. So of course we've got it's exactly the same build anyway. As we can see, you have still this little gimmick right there, which works perfectly again. Of course, you've got the two points of articulation on each arms and legs, so you can do some pose like that. But it's kind of a limited pose because you tend to do always the same type of pose anyway. Right there. And of course you got the ball mode, so just gonna maybe show you it. And then it will be only all about the Baroque, this first review of Baroque Cal, because there's not so much to tell about it anyway. And here you go, bad shape Boracal. It's kind of hard to make it roll, but anyway it's still roll, so it kind of works. It's not really impossible anyway. And you can put this into the canister to store it more easily, so just have to put this like the Borac with this little part, as you can see, and this hole right there. And there you go. Yeah, it's kind of funny because it does not really like that anymore. And I think that's all. So I'm just gonna Yeah, I'm just gonna just remade it into the Baroque forms and then sum up some stuff about the Baroque palace anyway, but there are not really much to tell about this one. So right here, and then put this like that. So let's see, I've still this one to review, but anyway, here is the normal Levacal, so just for comparison, little comparison shot. Right here. And then I'm gonna do a little sum up about these two ones. So, of course, in terms of new stuff and in terms of building, the Baroque are nothing interesting because they are exactly the same as the Baroque, which were already clones. So, as I've said earlier, they are clones of clones. So, really, that's not really interesting to build when you have already built like six Baroque anyway. So, but personally, I really like the storyline because I really like the idea of the some elite troops of Baroque. So I really especially like the storyline, but in terms of set, it's really really bad because it's the same as the other. But in terms of color scheme and stuff like that, it's kind of nice. So I really like the storyline and the color scheme. It's really effective with the silver parts and the normal colors parts. So really. Nice. You still got new parts like this one and of course the weapons part and lots of useful recolors like for example the silver feet and of course this little part which can be really useful to mock some Matawan for example or some other creations. So really they're really useful because they are in these colors and unlike the box one which were like in the lime colors and stuff like that, so they're kind of more hard to use in the mocks anyway. So really a nice they're really nice part packs if you see what I mean, so nice part packs, but in terms of set and new stuff they're really bad in my opinion because it does not bring any new stuff. They just recycle the Baroque design, and I think that's it's made because as you can see the worksheets bring like 90% of new parts and were only a revolution. So maybe they decided to put because their Lego designers are also limited in the number of new parts they can introduce new years. I think they decided to introduce most of the new parts into the worksheet and then just do simple Baroque with six or 12 new parts if you count these parts as new parts anyway, but just new pictures on it. So six new parts if I just count the weapon. So I think they really decided to put all the new parts they can have, all the budget for the new parts into the worksheet and not into the Baroque. So that's why we've got some clones of clones. But apart from this fact, I think that if you can find them at a cheap price, they are really still nice because of the color scheme of the parts packs and the storyline is kind of nice also in my opinion. But apart from that, I think if you have already some Baroques, just get one Baroque card and one or two normal Baroques and it will be okay. Anyway, if you are a fan of Baroques, I of course recommend you to get the six Baroque cards. But still, I think that's also a really subjective point, so really anyone will find the one which he prefers because you know, it's the same stuff, it's the same design, so it's all about your taste. I think it's all about your taste on which Baroque you prefer or which is the better because they're all the same, so it's kind of hard to tell which is the best in an objective way anyway. But I think these two are still doing nice in my opinion. They're still good. They're not my the one I prefer in terms of Baroque, but they're still nice. So I think that's all up to you. And I think that's all from our review. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any comments, just post them. I will read this. So I hope you enjoy this and see you later for another review. Bye bye.